Hello, my name is Brian Mitelo, and I welcome you to the King's Manual. Well, today we're going to talk about the power of your mind and the importance that it has to your destiny. Now, Genesis chapter number 11 and verse, let's say 6, but I'll start from 5 for your understanding. And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower which the children of men builded. And the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they have all one language, and they began to do. And now nothing will restrain from them which they have imagined to do. So I'll draw your attention to the last verse that says, that nothing shall restrain them, nothing shall stop them. This is God coming down to say, the thing that these guys have imagined to do, nothing shall stop them. Nothing shall stop them. I was expecting God, the supernatural being, to be able to say, I, God, is going to save them. Now, one thing that you need to realize is that God has given a power to man, the power to decide. That is why he said, today I call upon you to choose either life or death, but I recommend that you choose life. Every day that comes, life brings to us choices, and it is the choices that we make every day that will determine the quality of life that we're going to have. Now, the quality of the decision that you make is determined on how much or how well your mind is empowered. Okay, a lawyer is able to be paid huge amounts of money because he has taken time to develop his mind. A photographer, for example, they earn a lot of money because they've developed their mind. So in as much as you're a Christian, you're believing God for big things, you're believing God for this thing, have you developed your mind towards that thing? We call a person a doctor or whatnot because he spent time to develop his mind towards a specific thing in medicine. Like the scripture, the thing that they've imagined to do, no man is going to stop them. So if you take your time to build your mind, to find knowledge and wisdom as it relates to what you want to do, get your mind empowered, number one, by reading relevant books as it relates to what you desire. Number two, by finding people of like mind, which you can call mentors. The Lord bless you. Thank you.